Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In the previous episode, we saw the effect of using Ninja, Clang, and Zcash. In this episode, I'll look at pre-compiled headers. How much can I gain from using those? Pre-compiled headers. That is not a new technique. I remember teaching people about the existence, at least, of pre-compiled headers already 10, 15 years ago. But CMake got support for pre-compiled headers recently, and now it's actually super trivial to turn it on in your build step. And we'll see the benefit of that. But first, what is pre-compiled headers, or PCH for short? Well, it is this concept that you have, if you look at your include, you have a huge amount of lines that are the same for every single file. Namely, if you include, say, Qt Widget, that takes in, 20, 30, 40,000 lines of code that your compiler needs to go through. And it needs to do that for every single file. So why not just do it once and then just take the converted blip-blop from that and just use that next time you compile a file? That's the whole setup in pre-compiled headers. It requires one thing, namely that the first few lexical tokens of each and every file should be the same. We support that with CMake now, so that is an easy one. You don't need to go and modify every single file. And it requires that it is not too much of that. At least that's what my data shows me when I did my test. I recompiled my application again and again and again, so much for saving power for the good of the environment. And here in my spreadsheet, you can see it. So 150 seconds for my make clean make step. That's, you saw that as 148, 147 in previous sheets. That is the same number that you see here. No usage of pre-compiled headers gave me that. Then I created a pre-compiled header with just one header for each of them, namely Qt Core. Qt Core is that include file for every single thing that Qt that is in the Qt Core. So it's QString, it's QVector, it's QVariant, it's a lot of stuff. And that got me down to 109. That is 40 seconds I saved. And I'll show you in just a few steps. Very few lines of CMake magic code needs to go in here. Then I said, okay, Qt Core and Qt GUI. And it actually went up, even though there was more that was pre-compiled already. And you can see it doesn't get any better. I also tried just with Qt Widget, not as good either. So that made me think, am I already including too much when I include Qt Core? Because let me just show you Qt Core here, what it looks like. Qt Core include Qt Core dependencies. It include, and you can see there's quite a bit, Qt Buffer, Qt Bit Array. I don't think I ever used a Qt Bit Array. Shame on me, but I don't think, but I'm still paying for that. And there's quite a bit of stuff here. So what I did was I went back to my test setup here and I changed it so that I could include just one file. Well, actually, my test setup was searching for how many times I included stuff. And it was a slightly complicated and slightly erroneous possibly because I was many of the header files or many of the CPP file that I compile, they include stuff based on what the file that got generated by UIC. So I had to compile or run UIC step in my build and then count those CPP file and my own CPP file. And you can easily imagine a header file from or one UIC header file being included in many different, so slightly wrong. But nevertheless, it gave me a setup of memory being the high score here, 489 times, Qt application 180 times, which made me, where do I even need Qt application? Where do I? And then I looked, and it's actually the UIC generated files that has the Qt application in there, and so on. And you can see how many times for lots of different files. Then I tried saying, okay, let me, again, with zero. That's 147, there was 150 on the previous sheet. It goes up and down a bit based on how much loaded my computer is, I guess. With one file, 138. So if I just include memory, I go down to 138. If I include memory and Qt application, I go down to 95. And let me just take you to the other sheet over here. I went to 109 with Qt Core. So if I skip Qt Core and just include Qt application and memory, I go down to 95. That's way below. And you can see the graph over here. We have a sweet spot around here with 5. So if I include memory, Qt application, Qt variant, Qt widget, and possibly Qt box layout, I will go down to 87 seconds for compiling the whole thing. And let me just go back here. Just for you to look at the numbers here, it is these 191 Clang, no, GCC make, and no CC cache in there, gave me 191 seconds by just going, changing from make to ninja, changing from GCC to Clang, and now adding pre-compiled headers and including these few here at the top, I went all the way down to 87 seconds. That is quite a bit of an improvement. Let me show you what you need to do to get this gain up. Remember, 95 seconds down from 100 and something. That's a pretty significant one. That is worthwhile a bit of code. The code looks like this. First, I'm checking whether I want precompiled support at all, and it should be on. It's actually useful to not do precompiled support in your CI, so that you can validate that it actually does work should you one day end up in a system where it doesn't support precompiled headers. The last thing you want is that you include these 5-6 files in every single CPP file if you do not have precompiled header support, because then it will be really slow. But with precompiled header support on or off with this option here, it will just not have those. The next thing I test is whether I'm actually using a CMake version greater than 3.16. That was when precompiled header support came in CMake. If not, well, then I'll go back to the old way. Otherwise, I'll say here, yes, I'm using it. Isn't that awesome? And then I'll have target precompile headers. I will say that I should have a precompile header for this library here. And public, if I say public, then they will be used for subtargets, as it says here in the comment. And then here is the file that contains my precompiled headers. And that's the file that you see down here. So if I have precompiled header support, my CMake will actually spit these 8 lines here in front, well, not the first one then, but spit those in front of every single C++ file that it compiles. You can look at the command line parameters for CMake or for your compiler when you run CMake to see exactly what they are. And then it will use the precompiled headers. If I one day decide not to use my precompiled headers, I can just not use it. And every single compile file should be compilable still by themselves. And you can see that my precompiled header here included, I don't know, Qt widget, for example, but still, if I was using Qt widget in this file here, I would still want Qt widget to be included up there. One more line that I need in here, and actually I should have a test similar to this one if the version is greater than 3.19, because in 3.19 and when using Clang, they actually has the ability of instantiating the templates in the pre-compilation step, and that saves quite a bit of time. When I did it without this line, when I turned it on, I think I got something like 15 seconds speed up by just adding this one line. So that is absolutely have it on there. If you're compiling with Clang, yay, you get it. If you're using GCC, well, that line will just be a no-op. So do add this line here, and that's it. I did one more thing to speed up my compilation. And if you can see here on my screen now, you can see what is taking the longest time when I'm just touching one single file here and I compile. You can see that it's sitting there in the linking step for 6.4, 6.4, for some reason 7.5. Well, that reason is you. I'm recording, so my computer is putting a lot of bits onto the hard disk. But besides the point, I've changed one more thing, because this is the default default linker that comes. And there's actually quite a bit of articles out there that tells you that there is another linker called LLD. That's the one that comes with the LLVM, where Clang also comes from. And doing this one line here, I now switched to that one. I just went down to use a bin, and I'm rude, as you can see. And hide is just a script to make it go away by not deleting it. And now I'm linking, so LD is now a link to ld.lld, which is that other one. You might set it up on your builds or on your system using the alternatives. On my Kubuntu system, I couldn't figure out. But all that aside, let's try now. Touching the same file and timing. Done. Woohoo! Where did those 8s and 8s and whatnot seconds go? I was down to 1 second. I saved, well, up here when I wasn't loaded, you could see that it took 7. Oh, that was a previous build. So 7 seconds down to 1 second. That is 6 seconds that is saved for every single time that I change anything. So that's just a, I wonder if I should do it like this. Compile. 6 seconds sitting there waiting for the linker. Now down to 1 second. If 1 second is still too much for you, there's actually the guy who wrote the LLD linker has written a new one that's even more parallelized. So if you have a lot of cores on your computer, you might want to go check that out. I'll put it in the notes below. It still says this is just a toy on his page, so I don't dare using that myself. And going from 1 to 0.7 wasn't worthwhile for me. But if it takes already a lot of time for you in your linking stage, try it out and tell me in the show note below how that worked out for you. So if you're in Linux, do you use Ninja? Do you use Clang? Use pre-compiled headers and time how much of an improvement that gives you. My script, which is available below, is definitely a good starting point for you to check it out. And do post in the comments below what kind of speed gain you got. After all, Clang and Ninja were just a few different letters to your compile setup. And pre-compiled headers were, 6, 7 lines in your CMake file. And that was all. It's pretty darn easy to get quite a bit of an improvement, I'd say. I hope you enjoyed the previous and this episode. I will be putting out a few more episodes on my experience of going back to Linux after 4 years of being on the dark side. I've been using Linux, well, that's a story over a beer that you'll be paying now that I saved you a lot of CPU time. I hope to see you in real life someday. Until then, have a great time.